So we will start our day two of this session right now. So how was the day one for all of you? Just type in the chat if it was relaxed, calmful, peaceful. So how was your day one after our session yesterday? Just type in the chat window so I know how it went for all of you. Okay, peaceful, great. Sheetal, relaxed, wonderful. Sumant, Meenal, peaceful, relaxed, good, great. I hope for rest everybody it's gone really wonderful and it had been amazing one. Okay, great, Akshata, amazing sleep after a long slept for 12 hours. That's fantastic. Okay, that's really good. Relaxing, de-stressing, calm. Shilpa, you might have to probably adjust your audio as well, as you would have to check, because I'm assuming others are able to because they are responding. Great. Okay, good. Great. So now we are going to go on day two, and I hope all of you have kept at least have a glass of water or a water bottle with you, and in case if you have some fruits or something to bless the food, because today we are going to work on the day two. Let me just do a quick recap of what we did yesterday. So yesterday we were focusing on the internal balance, and in that we focused on creating an internal balance with the chakra that we would want to, and also writing down what our ideal weight is that you're looking for. So in the terms of chakras, we are focused on the root chakra and the chanting of the associated mantra Lam. And then we have moved on to the sacral chakra, the chanting of the mantra Vam, and then throat chakra, the chanting of the mantra Hum. We also did a group distant healing so that you could feel and understand the vibrations, and you can start feeling how it is happening within your own body inside. The other important aspect in terms of weight loss is the food that you eat. So connecting with the food energy is what we are going to do today. And the key thing that we are going to look at from a food perspective is, I just want you to take some time of yours right now and just think over the questions that I'm asking you. So from a food perspective, do you eat everything you want? Just type yes or no in the chat window. Do you eat everything you want? It's a full view itself on the screen, but maybe Suvarna, you can answer the question. Do you eat everything you want? Okay, we have a few of them saying no, a few of them saying yes. Then do you hold back from certain foods or drinks? Do you hold yourself from having certain food or drinks? Yes, 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 you do. Then we are talking about the next part is, do you eat what your body wants, or you wait for your stomach to tell you, yes, this is where I want and this is what I want? Okay, so you eat what your body wants, Ankit, fantastic. And don't wait for the stomach, just go ahead and eat, yes. Because these are the things which will help us to build our connect. And then how many of you just eat out of your own will, or you wait for some trainer or a nutritionist to tell you what has to be done? So if you wait for a trainer or a nutritionist to tell, own will, yes, that's fantastic, Sheetal. Sumant Cravings for the food, Kiran, nutritionist, Bhagyalakshmi No, Padma Onwill, Isha Onwill. That's fantastic. So we have a good amount of people here who eat the food based on their own will. So that's fantastic. So it's going to be much more interesting, because when you're eating with your own will, the connection that you're going to build with the food is going to be much more stronger. Wow, own will, that's fantastic. That's really, really good. And then, so do you eat whatever you want, but you must work out daily? Anybody has with that saying that, okay, I can eat anything, but I need to maintain the weight, and for that I need to do a workout. So how many of you do a workout? It could be a walk, it could be any form of exercise. So if you do any form of exercise, just go ahead and type yes. So I know that, okay, yes, workout is done. Few of you do yoga, few of you go for a walk. Some of you no workout, walk. Okay, great. So that's good. So you have some form of the activities also. Okay, so yes, do exercise, but not in lockdown at the moment. Okay. Ketki at times, and Janvi, yes, she also does. Padma, no workout. Okay. So the reason why we are talking about this is because we are going to let go of these blocks also in terms of our belief. Yes, of course, to maintain a healthy weight, you need to have a balance between with what you're eating, with your exercise, to make sure that your joints, your body has the right set of the movement and the strength. So it's not like, okay, if I'm eating too much, I need to do a lot of workout. It has to be, yes, I eat the right food, but at the same time, I am maintaining or doing my workout to make sure that my body remains, like my bones, my strength of my muscles is there. And not like, because I eat so much, so I need to burn it out, because that kind of a mindset doesn't work when you have to look for reaching at your ideal weight. So that's fantastic. So good. Now what we are going to do before we get into the next part of the activity, I would want all of you to sit in a relaxed form, because we are going to now do the healing. We are going to do the chanting and some of the beliefs which you have been forming right now. From your weight perspective, we are going to work on getting those released. Okay, so I want you to sit in a relaxed, comfortable position, whatever it feels like for you. Just sit comfortably, relaxed, with your back relaxed, with your body completely relaxed. Take a comfortable position, because it's going to take us it will take us another 5 to 7 minutes minimum. Okay. Sit relaxed, and you are at a safe place wherever you are. So just be relaxed that you're at a safe place, and virtually also you are at a safe place, because we are going to do the chanting of those three chakras, as well as we are going to release those blockages that we are creating in terms of our belief with the food, because food is a form of energy, and whatever we eat, wherever it comes from, it gives us a lot of, I would say, the vibration. So it's always been said, the kind of food that you're eating matters a lot. And the most important is how the food is cooked. If the food is cooked in anger, the food carries a lot of anger energies. Food is also a form of energy. You would have always noticed it, that when you cook food, or when your mom cooks food, or someone else cooks food, if there are the anger related energies. So if somebody is not cooking food in a good mood, that gets reflected while you're eating. Okay. And this was one experiment that was being done in one of my classes, where we had two jars. In both the jars there was tea, and one was the jar where I had energized it with the healing energies, with Reiki energies. And the other one was that I had not energized it. So there were two jars, one energized with positive energies using Reiki as a technique. Second, it was not being energized. It was a regular, both of them looking same. Both of them had tea. And during the break time of one of my face-to-face classes, I just asked the participants to go ahead and pick up and have their tea in the break time. So it was a wonderful thing. What happened was everybody, so the one which was energized was kept on the left-hand side and the non-energized was on the right-hand side. Everybody, almost, we had 10 to 15 participants and almost 12 participants went to the jar where the tea was being energized and they felt the taste to be really very different. They liked the taste. Whereas the same recipe, on the right-hand side also there was a jar with the tea, but only two or three had gone there. And so you see, if the food has the positive energies, the kind of attraction that it also has is positive, and people are automatically drawn to those positive and they start feeling those vibrations and energies within. So the idea here is that it's been experimented, and I do this kind of experimentations a lot during my training sessions face to face. And I would want you to do that as well today, because once we do this chanting and the healing, then the next part that I told and asked you to bring is a glass of water or at least a bottle of water. You will be able to see the difference of how it goes. And if you're able to do it daily, that will be fantastic. And this is something which I'll tell you is not something which has been innovated or created right now. This has been there since ages in our tradition, or in fact, in every tradition. This has always been there, that when you're cooking food, it has to be with happiness, with joy, or whenever you are connected with food, whenever you're having your food, whenever you're eating food, it has to be with that joy and happiness. So that's the idea of letting you know why we are talking about connecting with the food, because irrespective of whatever healthy food you eat, but if you're not eating it with the right energies, positive energies and right mindset, it will not really affect you in terms of your health. If you're eating food with the right intention and the right food, it will start impacting your health in a positive way. And that's why it's been said that how the food is cooked, where does the food come from, which place does the food come from, what kind of energies it stores is very, very important. Because if there has been a lot of negative things happening around where the food has been growing, and then that comes to you, then that somewhere or the other reflects, because everything around us is a form of energy. And especially if it is not a living form, then the energies are stored the way it has been reflected in that particular environment. So that's the idea of why we are focusing today on connecting the food. So I hope by now you would have found a comfortable place for yourself to sit. I would want you to close your eyes. Just close your eyes. Keep your hands in the receiving position, your palms facing upward. And you can have your palms kept on your lap. Close your eyes. Be comfortable. You are at a safe place, at your home or whichever place you are. And you are also virtually safe. You're safe and protected. So just relax. And let us do a few deep breaths. Inhale. Slowly hold your breath, exhale. Inhale, slowly hold your breath, exhale. Inhale, slowly hold your breath, exhale slowly. Just say, I am open and receptive to the group distant healing being given by Poonam right now. I thank the Supreme God, the divine energies, the healing energies to be present here in this moment to help me, heal me, guide me, and protect me. I'm receptive to the group distant healing being given by Poonam right now. And just imagine above your head, there is this purple, light purple color ball. And the reason why we are using a purple color today is to remove and release any thoughts, blocks, cages that you have with regards to your weight, with regards to the food that you're eating. It's getting released and diminished right now. And when I say released, you can imagine it as a gray form of energy getting released, moved out from your body, and just observe which part of the body it releases. So that any pain, any stress, any tension that you're going to have is going to go away right now in this moment. And we are working on the emotional healing for each one of you right now. So that if there are any emotional blockages because of which you're either having hormonal imbalances or overeating or not able to have the control on the quantity of food that you're eating or the cravings that you're having, because all of this definitely denotes physically maybe some deficiencies which needs to be worked upon, and at an emotional level, the stress that you're facing is getting released right now. And as you just see above your head, there is this purple, light purple, violet, bright colored ball. And as this ball is coming down, it's coming down in the form of a bright violet energy. And slowly and gradually, this violet color ball from the right side of your body is going slowly, slowly down. It's going down. From the right side of your body, it's going down, down. It's touching your feet and then going upward towards the left side of the body and touching back at the top of your head. Again, it's forming a circle from the right. It's going down to your feet and then on the top of your head. This is the third circle which it is forming. And as this third circle is getting formed, there is a lot of bright light and warm feeling that you can feel. As this light is moving from the right side, slowly and gradually, it's going down to your feet and then onto the left side and at the top of your head. It's forming a circle right to left and front and the back of your body. Front and the back of the body, again, imagine the purple color is moving from the top. It's coming to the front side of your body towards your face, slowly going down, touching your feet, and from there back, it's coming at the top of your head. Second circle, it's going down slowly and gradually. This purple color ball, violet color, bright ball is forming a circle and it's coming to the top of your head. And again, a third circle coming front, touching the feet, and from the back coming at the top of your head. So now you see that there is this purple violet color ball which has been formed. And from this ball, there are this bright purple light. And it's a very soothing light which is coming in. And as this light is coming to your crown chakra, which is the top of your head, you see or you feel or imagine that it's a very bright light coming slowly down releasing any stress, any tension. So any extra weight that you're carrying of emotions, mentally, physically, emotionally or spiritually, it's coming down, it's releasing. Any pain, anything that you're feeling in any part of your body is also getting released with this. Because the pain denotes the emotional imbalance. And because of this, there is stress. Because of stress, you have physical health issues and then resulting into a weight which does not fit into your ideal health. Now this light is coming down slowly. Just imagine and feel the warmthness with your eyes closed. Feel the warmthness of this purple light coming down from your top of the head. It is covering your forehead. Slowly it's covering your face, front and back, covering your throat. Yesterday we learned that throat is one of the key chakras for bringing your weight into balance of what you're looking for. So imagine this purple color is releasing, it's moving and pushing any stress, any tension that you have in your throat right now, moving out in the form of gray energy and replacing it with positive energies. We're going to chant the mantra hum 3 times so that you feel the energies and vibrations. Hum. 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 Relax, and with this chanting, the purple light has become much more brighter. Your throat has become much relaxed. Your throat chakra is open. And you are, from today onwards, more expressive. You're able to work out towards expressing your emotions in the right way, which is helping you to live a happy, healthy life. And now slowly and gradually, this purple light is coming down. So any stress, any tension that you feel on the upper back, on both the sides of your shoulders, right and left, this energy is flowing. It's touching your elbows, both sides, right and left, your palms, and each and every finger. It's releasing. It's like a coating being formed of this purple, bright color to release any stress emotions and replace it with positive ones. So you feel much more lighter and relaxed. This is bringing that shift. It is triggering the shift of the energies positively in your body. Your upper back, middle, and then lower back. And from the front, your chest, your upper part of the stomach, solar plexus is what we call, 2 inches above, and slowly it's coming down to your navel. And now when you are at your navel, yesterday we did talk about it, which is a sacral chakra. This chakra plays a very important role, controlling the stress part of your body. So any stress, any tensions which are there, this is the chakra which controls the stress levels in your body. And let us work and imagine that this purple color ball is working to release any stress, any tensions, any pain that you have. So head till your navel, front and the back, both hands, any stress, any tension is getting released. Just say, I'm open and receptive to this group distant healing being given by Poonam right now, feeling relaxed. And let us chant the mantra associated with the sacral chakra, which as you can see is Vam. So let us chant the mantra Vam 3 times. Vam. Focusing on your navel and in and around. 2nd time. Vam. Third time, imagine now this purple color, violet color, is helping you release any blocked emotions that you have and any negative beliefs that you're carrying with regards to food, that this food doesn't help me, this is causing a problem. Let us release those. 3rd time chanting of the mantra. Vam. Let's feel the energies, vibrations. Be receptive to these energies, which is helping you to release any extra weight. Or a lot of you had things with any extra body fat that you have in any part of your body, be it tummy, be it thighs, arms, is getting melted down with this purple color and emotions are getting flowed. So if you feel like crying, screaming, shouting, let that happen. Now we're moving slowly down, focusing onto your root chakra, base of your spine. The mantra to chant is Lam. And let us chant the mantra Lam. Intention is the root chakra is helping you to stay stronger and reach your ideal weight of whatever the number is. Be receptive to the group distant healing and let's do. Lam. 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 Be receptive, feel the energies, vibrations. This light is moving further down, covering your thighs, right to left leg, your knee, your ankles, your feet, head to toe. With this bright purple light, any emotions, negative blockages that you had are released completely. Any extra body weight that you're carrying is getting released right now in this moment from today onwards. Any extra fat that you're carrying in your body is getting released right now in this moment. You're reaching to your ideal weight, which is helping you to stay fit and fine. Any pain, any stress in any part of your body is also getting released right now, instantaneously. Just be receptive. This light is replacing each and every cell with healthy, fit energies. So you can absorb the food and the nutrients in each and every cell of your body. Feel the energies, vibrations, be receptive to the healing. I'm open and receptive to the group distant healing being given by Poonam right now. And I'm just going silent for a couple of moments. You continue imagining that any stress, any tensions, or just visualize, imagine that the body, extra body weight is getting dropped down into the earth. Any extra body fat is getting dropped down into the earth. Be receptive to the group distant healing. Slowly and gradually, come back to the room that you are in right now. Come back to the room that you are in right now. Come back to the room that you are in right now. Be comfortable. Just say to yourself, I'm happy, I'm healthy, and open and receptive to all the positive changes coming in my life with regards to my health. I'm reaching my weight, the ideal health in the moment. Okay. Now slowly and gradually just open your eyes with a big smile and tell me, how has your experience been? You can just type in the chat window of how did you feel. Devi Bala, very relaxing. Good. That's nice. You should feel much more lighter and relaxed because a lot of blocked emotions that you had in terms of things being there in regards to your weight is getting there. Relaxed and sleepy. Yes, Eileen, sometimes you will go to sleep. You're just doing superb feeling, Bhagya. Thanks. Felt lighter, warm all overall. Good. Light and relaxed. Relaxed. Slight pain in right ankle onward, downwards. Yes, Bharati, it will slowly start moving out. Oh, felt a sweet thing. That's nice. Relaxed, sleepy, and warm palms. That's fine. That's fantastic, Padma. You could visualize the purple as well. That's fine. One thing I want to tell is because a lot of you might be doing this visualizations or the imaginations that I'm asking for the first time. But it's okay, even if you're not able to get a color in front of you, don't worry. The healing is still happening. The thought and the intention with which you're doing is the most important part of the thing. So here we move. Okay, wow, that's fantastic, Sheetal. Yes, you are, and you are reaching to your ideal weight in the days that you're looking for. That's nice, Kiran. Some movements in root chakra, that's good. That means your vibrations and healings have started happening. The shifts in your energies and the body weight will start happening sooner. Calm vibrations were flowing throughout the body. That's nice, Ketki. Good to know that. Okay, so now we are moving to the next part, which is the most important part of the thing that I said. And I told you about it some time ago of what we are referring to here in terms of the food. The important part here is two things, as I said. One, while you're cooking the food is very, very important because it has the vibrations. And maybe if you have not cooked the food, then giving energies to your food is also important. Now, there are different techniques which you can use. If you guys have learned any kind of a healing modality, you may use that kind of thing. Generally, because I have been teaching Reiki and I'm into Reiki since a long time. Since 1995, I focus more on using the Reiki energy healing technique. So Reiki is one of the energy healing technique. Now, what we are going to do is, this is something which I would want you to practice every day, which we are going to do right now. What we are going to do is we are going to bless our food and the energies. But before we do that, what I would want you to do is, let me stop sharing and let me put my video on the spotlight so you guys can see it. Okay. Now, when I say, so I told you to get, you can get a glass of water or a bottle of water, whatever is possible, just go ahead and get that for yourself. If you have not, I would want you to go and get that. Take a moment, go and get it. In case if you already have it, I would want you to just like put this left hand and your right hand above. And for this moment, I just want you to stay silent and feel the vibrations of water. Keep your hands in a cup position so that you can feel the vibrations much faster. because keeping sometimes in a this position, it takes a longer time. But if you do this, just keep it. And if you would want to close your eyes, just close your eyes. And there is nothing to say right now. Just feel the vibrations. What do you sense in your left palm, which you have kept this way, and the one that you have kept on the top? Any hand is fine, Saili. You can keep your left down or right above or left. So depending on what your primary, like the most dominant hand you use, you can do it. Any hand is fine. Because I'm more of a, like a right-handed person. So my right hand generally, by natural, it goes on the top and left goes at the bottom. So just feel the vibration. If you are having water or if you're having any food items, just feel it. I'll just be silent for some time so you can feel and sense whatever you can right now. In the moment, if anybody feels any sensations or any vibrations or any kind of a feeling or a thought that comes in, just type on the chat window so I know that you have felt something. It can be a vibration, it can be a thought, it can be anything. Okay, Kiran feels like something like waves. Okay, anybody else could just feel any sensations? Okay, so Devi Bala feels left hand at bottom felt numb. Okay, fine. So, and you can keep your, like if you have started feeling certain sensations, you can keep the glass again. Numb and ticklish is what Sampada feels. Okay. Energy passing in water, Bhagya, yes. Thought, tremendous power in water. That's good. Bharti, fantastic. Bottom hand, cold and heavy. Top hand, neutral. Okay, Sumant. Great. So whatever sensations or thoughts have come in, you just can go ahead and put that, because before we do this other part of the experiment, I wanted to let you know and feel this, because you will then start to know what the difference is when we are actually going ahead with the next part of the session. Great. Anybody else? Anything? Yes, Padma says warm tingling feeling on the top hand, bottom hand from cold became warm slowly. Okay. Feeling a push on the top hand. Janvi could hear seashore waves. Wow, that's good. Waterfalls. Warm is what Ketki felt. Yogita, vibrations. Bottom hand cold and heavy. Water vapor coming up and touching my hand. Okay, Saili, fantastic. Okay, so yes, so these are a lot of things which you are feeling, and this is what you would always feel. So today we are doing it with the water. Tomorrow you can do with every food item. And this is one technique or tip which I will share with all of you, which you can do. And that's what I'm saying. This is not something which I have invented all. I have been practicing it since a longer time, and it is something which has always been available with us. So it's just that we have forgotten. Okay. Now what I want you to do is, again, take your water, keep your hand again, and I'm going to guide you this time. Okay. I'm going to guide you and give healing. So right now what we are going to do is we are giving the energies of what you have felt and whatever. So if anybody has learned any healing modality, they can use that, or people who have done Reiki can use the energies by invoking. We'll do the invocation, and level 2, level 3 people in Reiki can use those symbols as well. So you can draw the symbols on the water. Or any other healing modalities, if you have learned any positive symbols to charge things, just use that. So right now, keep your left and the right on the top. Let us just invoke the positive energy. So I invoke the Supreme God, the divine energies, the healing energies to be present here in this moment to heal this water or whatever food item you're having in your hand, to heal that instantaneously right now and to charge it with positive energies. And now we are going to say three times an affirmation, which I'm reading it out for you. We are going to say, may this food or the water be cleansed of any negative energies and effects, and may the key and the energy and the nutrition of this food be increased to its maximum potential. I send a blessing to all those that have worked hard so that I may be nourished by this food. Thank you, Mother Earth, and thank you, Father Sky, for the blessing of these resources. I honor my body, mind, and spirit, and ask that this nourishment be accepted into every level of my being. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I will share this affirmation with all of you in the broadcast message, but at the moment, just feel the sensations and vibrations and be receptive to the group distant healing that I am passing to each one of you. We are going to read this affirmation second time. Just carefully listen to it. May this food be cleansed of any negative energies and effects, and may the key and nutrition of this food be increased to its maximum potential. I send a blessing to all those that worked hard so that I may be nourished by this food. Thank you, Mother Earth, and thank you, Father Sky, for the blessing of these resources. I honor my body, mind, and spirit, and ask that this nourishment be accepted into every level of my being. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Continue feeling the sensations and thoughts that would come in, because we are now going to do the affirmation for the third time. Carefully just listen to it and sense any vibrations or sensations that you can feel in your palms while you're holding your glass of water or the food. May this food be cleansed of any negative energies and effects, and may the key and nutrition of this food be increased to its maximum potential. I send a blessing to all those that worked hard so that I may be nourished by this food. Thank you, Mother Earth, and thank you, Father Sky, for the blessing of these resources. I honor my body, mind, and spirit, and ask that this nourishment be accepted into every level of my being. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Just feel the sensations, vibrations. I'm going silent for a couple of moments while I'm giving you group distant healing. So be receptive to this healing. Be receptive. I'm open and receptive to the group distant healing being given by Poonam right now. The food, the water that I'm charging is full of positive energies, helping me and whoever eats or drinks the water to reach at the optimum health and nutrition in their body. Come back to the room, and slowly and gradually you may open your eyes and share with me the experience that you had with regards to this. this is the affirmation that we had done. I will share it with you, but I would now need to know, how was your experience after we did this blessings? Somehow I'm not, I need to stop sharing to see your chats. Felt vibrations on both hands. Water was coming with full energy, warm and full from inside of the palm on the top hand. Feeling of gratitude. That's good. So you could understand the difference between before we did this blessings and the energy work and how it has been changed. The weight has increased. And even now when you drink this food or eat, you will start feeling the difference of the vibrations and the energies. Energies on the top hand, that's fantastic. Vibrations on the top hand, good. Somebody had felt heaviness in the hand. So after this, did they feel relaxation or was it much better? Energy on top hand. Yes, the heaviness reduced on the bottom hand. That's fantastic, Devi Bala. Water became warm with powerful energies. Water is revolving. Yes, Shilpa. That's good. So what I would want you guys to do is that, of course, we did yesterday, heaviness reduced Sheetal from the bottom hand. Yes. And we have just done for how much? We have just done it for a couple of minutes. But as I said, the more you practice this now, the two things that you have to do is, one, we have spoken about the chanting. You need to chant for your throat chakra, your sacral chakra, and your root chakra. So it is like, for the root, it is lam. For the sacral, it is vam. And for your throat chakra, it is hum. This three chanting, if you're able to do even 7 times once in your day, it'll help you to change the energy internally. And your emotions get released. And if you start charging your food, that's going to do wonders. So what you can do is, while you're cooking food or while you're storing the water, just spend 5 minutes of yours to charge the water and give the blessing. Wow, Ketki. So felt vibrations on top hand and water tastes different after the healing. Yes, because you'll start seeing the energies and vibrations changing in the food and the water. And if you can commit me of doing this for the next 21 days at least, because that's the time where you will start seeing a lot of shift in your energies and your weight as well. So are you committed to doing this 2 things at least for the next 21 days? Type C so that I know that you're committed. Water tastes sweet. Yes, Sadhana, that's fantastic. So committed. It just takes two minutes of your time. Okay, how do we charge food holding part? Okay, now if you have, I didn't get a plate, but then just assuming that this is the plate of the food, then you can charge it. But if at all, if it's too heavy, keep your food on the table. So like, for example, this is the food which is kept on the table and I'm charging it with my right hand. So your left hand may not be under your food, but you can have your right and the left hand like this placed above the food to charge it. Okay, so you can keep it like this, charge it. And yes, water tastes different and it even smells pleasant. That's fantastic, Siley. Yes, we have just done it for a few seconds or a few moments, but as you keep doing it daily, for the next 21 days, you'll start seeing a big shift. And I would in fact tell you that you just go ahead and do it daily. It takes only 2 minutes of your time. Okay, in the morning, going ahead, charging the water, wherever you store it, the water bottle, or if you're having a pot or whatever it is. And then the food, once it's cooked, just go ahead, bless it. Not only you, but everybody in your family can enjoy this. And in fact, it can be one of my friend does this. It's kind of a ritual for their family. Everybody in the family, whenever they're having, they'll charge the food. But they also do it as a group activity. Like, because of the lockdown, most of them are able to have food together. So they get the food together on the table. Everybody blesses the food with positive things and then they eat it. So you can also try doing this. It's a good family activity, plus letting your kids and every member in the family know about it and then do it. I will message you, Saili. I'll broadcast the affirmation that you need to say while blessing, because right now I had repeated it for you, but I'll tell you it's a very small thing. So any point of time you feel that it's carrying any negative energy, so irrespective of the type of food that you're eating, okay? Somebody had asked me if I'm eating a non-vegetarian food, is it okay if I just go ahead and bless? So whatever you're eating, just go ahead and bless that. Be it vegetarian, be it vegan, be it non-vegetarian or whatever. Just go ahead and bless. To that matter, even if it's a small chocolate, you can just hold it and bless it also. So that's one thing which I want each one of you to go ahead and do. So that was the day two. So day one, we have worked on our inner self. Day two, we have connected our energies with the food. And day three is much more powerful, coming with a few more techniques of visualization of your healthy self. So just go ahead and let's connect tomorrow. Congratulations on completing day two, and let's see and connect with you guys tomorrow. I am waiting to hear your experiences and feedback as you start implementing these two things from today onward. So people in India, I am assuming most of you would have had the dinner, but if not, go ahead and bless your food and then see. I'll send it to you in another 5 minutes, the affirmation. People outside of India, you have good time. So bless your lunch, bless your dinner. Just go ahead and do it. So thanks a lot, everyone. Have a good night. Have a good day. And let's connect back tomorrow for day three. Yeah, wonderful, Devi Bala. Thanks. Wow. Thanks a lot, Padma. Hope you guys are enjoying it and loving it. Your feedback helps me to know what needs to be improved in the next session. Great. Thank you, everybody. I'm here for some time in case if you have any questions. Post that, I will just disconnect the call.